Hello, I'm Fast Lawyer Mazakala Swift Reviews. Today we're going to review and play God's Challenge VR. God's Challenge VR is a game on the Steam Store for the HTC Vive and the Oculus Rift, released on the Steam Store on January 14th, 2020. It normally retails for $10. It's currently 60% off, only $4. However, I do not recommend this game. It's not just that it's basically a clone of Until You Fall. It's that it's a bad clone of Until You Fall. So it took the most basic elements of Until You Fall and it didn't add any of the complexity of that game. It didn't change the gameplay in any way. It just basically took the most basic elements and made that a whole game. This game basically consists of four levels. After you beat those four levels, and there is a boss at the end of each level, you are challenged to beat all four bosses in a row. And I believe after you do that, then you have another end boss fight. I didn't get that far. I got to the part where there's four bosses, and as you probably saw there, I don't know if you want to slow motion that, but it looks like I made a correct strike on time and it just didn't register. At the end of this video, the same thing happens right when I'm facing this same boss for the second time, which ultimately led to my death just because I couldn't get those to register correctly. I don't know if there's a hit marker problem. For whatever reason, the sword swings don't always register. I don't know if you just, there's only a specific area of the target where it counts. It doesn't seem to be based on timing, as far as I can tell. It might be that you just have to be really on target, much more than it looks like when you're swinging the swords. Anyways, that's the only thing that makes this boss fight difficult. In fact, this is really the only difficulty there is. The only major difficulty with this game is just staying awake, because you will be repeating the same actions over and over again. Probably the worst thing about this game is the trash on the way to the boss fights. The trash on the way to the boss fight is just very repetitive. There's never any change to the game mechanic at all on the way to the boss, you know, for the first four levels. And so if you fail at the boss, you're just going to have to go to the trash again, and that's one reason you don't want to die in the boss fight, because you just don't want to fight the trash again because it's just so boring. The first boss that you face off is exactly just like the trash, only a lot longer, so it's really just an endurance fight. How long can you keep doing the same thing over and over and over again without, you know, making a mistake? It just becomes so boring and so repetitive that that's really the only difficulty is, you know, you lose concentration just because you're repeating the action so many times over and over again. That first boss is the worst fight just because you're just, it's simple, it's a simple boss fight. You can easily beat that boss. It's just so long and so boring that you almost just want to die and quit. I kept on going. I actually wanted to beat the game, and I did again get all the way to the fifth level where you fight all the previous four bosses, and I did get to the very end of that challenge where you face this same boss that I just beat. But again, the head detection issues, I think, is what got me. And again, I'm not sure what the cause of that head detection issue is. I don't know if the game is just very punishing and having to be super precise in your sword swings. If I go super slow motion, I can see on the second attempt at the boss where my swing was just a little bit off of the mark, but it's still really close, and you're just wondering, wow, this game is really punishing if you have to be that precise with so many swings along the way, and the boss fights are just so long. Again, it's just more about being able to focus and being able to be persistent and not lose focus, because the fights are so long and they're so repetitive that you lose that focus. Overall, I did not enjoy this game. I don't recommend it, even at the sale price. Again, Until You Fall is so much better, And I would recommend saving your $4 and using that towards the purchase of Until You Fall if any of this gameplay looks interesting to you. Keep in mind, there's a lot more to Until You Fall than there is in this game, so do not think this is like Until You Fall. This is only the most basic elements of Until You Fall and made into a complete game, and that's why it's just not very interesting to play this game, and why I don't recommend it, even at the sale price. There are some interesting moments in this game, and there's like the inkling of what could be a good game. However, the majority of the gameplay is just boring and repetitive, so even for those few moments where the boss fights might look interesting, most of the boss fight is just boring. And I had to edit this video. I had to cut out major portions of the boss fights just because they were too boring to watch. I couldn't do that to you guys. It was boring to play, and it's even more boring to watch those boss fights. So this video is heavily edited. If I uploaded an unedited video, I don't think anybody would watch the entirety of the video, because it's just too long and boring, and you feel the same way when you're playing this game. There aren't many options in this game. You can play seated or standing. I didn't really notice too much difference. I think the game might be a little easier if you stand. But it does play well seated. I was surprised by that. And there are just not too many other options. By default, you have the vignette that you cannot take off. That's not really a big issue for me, because you can move faster. If you move both joysticks, you do move faster. And for the most part, you're not actually moving. You're just staying in your play space for the boss fights. And even the trash fights, you're staying in your play space. You're only moving after you defeated an enemy. So that's really not a big deal to me. Another thing wrong with this game is the story. So the story is just a bunch of text and some cinematic scenes. The problem is the texts are very short and they're just full of grammatical errors. It's very difficult to ignore that. I don't want to punish devs that are from foreign countries and they're making their game in English, you know, a foreign language to them. But in this case, it's just really bad translations and grammar. It really makes the story not make a whole lot of sense. And the story is just too simple. Like I said, it's just a bunch of text. Basically, there are 6 levels. You fight the trash, and then you go to the boss fight. And then for the 5th level, they didn't add anything new. You just refight the same 4 bosses that you just beat. That's a terrible mechanic. That's obviously something done by the dev to increase the playtime, but it does not make the game more enjoyable. In fact, it does quite the opposite. For that reason, I cannot recommend this game. I'm going to give this game a 4.5 out of 10. They were close to making something recommendable, but just the way it plays out, I can't recommend it. I even had thoughts of maybe I should refund this game. That's how badly I felt about that 5th level where you have to repeat the boss fights again, and then you have that hit detection issue that just makes it very frustrating, and you don't want to have to refight all 4 bosses again just because you failed with a hit detection issue. I'm Fast Lawyer. If you liked my video, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. Have a good one. Goodbye.